وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us in Surah Nisa, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, وإذا جاءهم أمر من الأمن أو الخوف أذاعوا به ولو ردوه إلى الرسول وإلى أولي الأمر منهم لعلمه الذين يستنبطونه منهم ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته لاتبعتم الشيطان إلا قليلا. For reflecting on the meaning of this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when something about security or fear comes, they just announce it and spread rumors. And if they take it back to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or to their leaders, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِتُونَهَ مِنْهُ. Some people will be able to analyze it properly and reflect properly and give us the right answers. وَلَوْ لَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَاتَّبَعْتُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. And if it wasn't for the bounty and the mercy of Allah, we would follow shaitan, إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, except a few. Subhanallah, as we all live through the sadness and what we watch through what's happening in Gaza, and I read the chat rooms and the news, and if we look at and reflect on the chats, what are we doing? You see on the chat rooms, everybody is blaming the leaders, blaming our governments, blaming. Everybody's blaming, and that's about it. Some people are calling for a jihad. Somebody else should go and fight. So you see somebody calling for a jihad, and he didn't say, I will go and do, join me, but somebody else should go and do jihad. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ قبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. Why do you say what you do not do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises the most is you say what you do not do. Somebody else should go and do the jihad. Somebody else should fight. Somebody. And we blame others. And did anybody reflect and say, what did I do? And when you ask any Muslim, what did you do? He says, what could I do? 1.5 billion people have the same answer, what could I do? It is our corrupt so-and-so. SubhanAllah, we have all become helpless. We've all been programmed that what could I do? 1.5 billion people, what could I do? It is the bad people. SubhanAllah. If we reflect how we've been programmed, and so we can sleep at night. We've been given this pill so we can all sleep at night. It is somebody else who's bad. Blame other people. And as I reflect on it, the enemies have improved on the oohs and ahs on how to hit the Muslims. And we have improved on how do we blame each other. Every time a problem happens, they say they have learned lessons on how to deal. And what is the lessons we have learned as Muslims? Is how to improve on blaming others. And alhamdulillah, we all go to sleep well because we have been able to blame these bad people. We're all good people except this few on top of us. Little do we know, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change what with people till they change themselves. It didn't say till they change their leaders. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Rasul tells us, يُوَلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْكُمْ. It is one of you who leads you. And if you think the leader, our leaders are bad, because we're all bad. And pick anybody, and the end result is the same. يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Change themselves. What have we done to change ourselves and our families? And then the leader. If we bring our children up on honesty, doesn't matter who's our leader in the next generation, because all our children are honest. But no, what do we tell our children? Become the best doctor or the best engineer, because the doctor makes a lot of money. So he perfects how he does more money. And then we wonder what happened to us. When this is our criteria, is all our children are doctors and engineers, and then we wonder what happened to us. Did we tell anybody to improve, to help mankind, to do this, to do this? No. It is because it's a good money-making machine. And they learn well, and they go and apply what they've learned well, and then we say, where is Salah al-Din? We did not create and instigate the new one. We have not. And as we said before, the prince who opened Al-Constantinia, Muhammad al-Fatih, his father always told him, son, make me proud. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said there will be a young prince who opened Constantine. I hope it's you. Since he is young, he put in him, I hope it's you, son, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described. Make me proud. And here we tell our children, make us proud. Be doctors, be engineers, make a lot of money. And they do make us proud, and we are proud of them. But we have to understand what we put in our children and what's the end result. And then Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bianfusihim. Allah will not change us till we change ourselves. And it is ourselves, not our leaders, not our governments, because our leaders and our governments, sadly, it's a reflection of us in the mirror. It is us. When we have more money and more power, we end up the same. And the question, we say, no, they are the bad bunch. I have this discussion with everybody. They are the bad bunch. We are good. I say, if so good, what government is controlling us here in Canada? A lot of us have left home maybe 20, 15, 30 years ago. And yet, are we united? Are we united in Canada? What's stopping us? Is it still these bad people? Are they still among us? It is something inside us. Allahubbana wa la taj'al fi qulubina ghillan lillazina amanu. In the Quran it says, I ask Allah, don't put any bad feelings for those who believe. And sadly enough, there is that feeling in our heart. In the year 2000, a young man seen what happened in Palestine and asked for a unity conference in Toronto. Let's bring the Muslims together in Toronto. And he asked a few people to speak, and I was one of them. It was a Saturday night. And then a Friday night, I get a call from another sheikh telling me, I want you to speak in a conference I'm having tomorrow. I told him, sorry, I am committed to this young man. And by the way, I seen your name on the roster of speakers too, on that unity conference. He said, I changed my mind, I'll have my own conference. I'll have my own conference. And let this young man down. Why? Because there is this ghill in our hearts. Not the government, the government had nothing to do with it. But each one of us hold on to power. What if this young man succeeds? Where is his power? Where is his place? So he has his own conference. He will tell us. And each one, or each imam of each masjid says, yes, unite, except under me. Each one is preaching unity, but he's the right person. And in Islam, it doesn't matter who. Because if we're all good, who cares who is the leader? The leader, if anything, is a responsibility, not an authority. In true Islam, none of us wants this leadership because we get the benefit without the responsibility. But because we don't have this iman in our heart, we want this leadership. We want the authority, but we give up the responsibility. And this is how it is. We have to wake up. There is no governments among us here. We are, alhamdulillah, almost free to do anything we like, and yet we fight among ourselves. About a year ago, the Muslims wanted to send a letter to the Prime Minister. So proudly, 124 imams signed it, because we don't have one voice to sign it. We are all proud. Nobody could represent me. 124 imams signing a letter to say, we are the Muslims that are united. If we're united, it will only take one signature to say, on behalf of the Muslims, we ask. But there is 124 imams. Each one is refusing to relinquish his authority because he loves it. That's how we are. Let's stop blaming our governments and blame ourselves and say, when are we changing? So we have to change. So we have to reflect on what's happening. Enough of the blame. The enemy's improved on the oohs and ahs, and we are improving on the blame. Since 2006, we lived the same thing when they destroyed Lebanon. And again, what did we do? Blame. And what happened after the war stopped in Lebanon? We went back to sleep again. Alhamdulillah, the problem has gone away. The enemy went and studied what did they do wrong and improved on it and said, we won't repeat the mistake. For us, we went to sleep. And then when the problem comes again, we wake up and blame again. Alhamdulillah, the same bunch is there for us to blame. And then if the ceasefire happens tomorrow, we all sleep again. Alhamdulillah, as if the problem is fixed. Problem is not fixed. We have to change from ourselves. And then inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change us. And if we look, how do we change? And that's the question, how do we change? We look at the answers on the chat groups, and I'm sure most of you have went Some blamed Egypt, some blamed the states, some blamed Israel, some blamed the government, some blamed everybody. And we noticed one thing, not one person said, we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Muslims in the time of trouble, as this ayah said that we started with, when we are in trouble, we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet we get an email right to the Prime Minister of Canada to condemn. The Prime Minister of Canada a year ago or over a year ago said, I unconditionally support Israel. Actually, it was in the newspaper the other day, in the Canadian newspaper. How could a Canadian Prime Minister unconditionally support another state? Unconditionally. He's not saying I'm unconditionally supporting peace or justice or anything. He's unconditionally supporting another state, whether they're right or wrong. And yet when we are in trouble, we go to this Prime Minister and say, please save us. When the Muslims in trouble, we have to learn, we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.